Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman, and I'm here to give you a taste of what you can do with virtual machines in Azure. Now, whether you're a developer, DevOps, a huge enterprise, or a small independent, Microsoft Azure is a hybrid cloud that can handle whatever you throw at it. Now, here in the web-based Azure portal, let's create a virtual machine. I don't have any VMs yet, but I can easily create one, both Windows Server or Linux, in minutes. I'll start by clicking Add. Now, there's a gallery of hundreds of different solutions to pick from. There's pre-configured VMs for everything you can imagine, from WordPress to Barracuda, as well as complete multi-VM solution templates for larger systems like SharePoint or WebSphere. Now, if you want to create a Linux VM, you can search for popular images like Ubuntu, but for this video, I'm going to create a Windows Server VM. I have lots of different versions to choose from. I'll go ahead and pick Windows Server 2016. Now let's go through the various options that you need to complete before creating a VM. First, we'll need to create a name for the VM instance. I'll call mine Scott's Windows VM. Now, the next thing is to create a disk that is attached to the VM. Now the options are hard drive or SSD. SSDs have higher performance and we recommend them for production environments. Next, I'll set up credentials for my VM. And I'll pick a resource group. My users are in West US, so that's where I'll put the virtual machine. Next, we need to pick the VM size. Now, you should choose the right VM for your workload based on the number of cores, the RAM, disk drive size, and price. Azure will give you VM recommendations based on popular sizes, but be sure to click on View All to select more VMs and get lots of different choices. I'm going to pick the DS1 V2 VM. This is going to give me 3.5 gigs of RAM, a good number of IOPS, and a nice local SSD. Now on this screen, there's a number of required VM options like a virtual network and a storage account, as well as optional services like a network security group. I'm going to leave it with the defaults. Now if you plan to have a group of VMs, you might want to create an availability set so that you can group your VMs together and then load balance traffic across them. We'll create a new availability set by selecting the High Availability option, and then click New on the next blade. I'll create Scott's Windows VM set. I need to set the number of update domains and fault domains. Multiple update domains ensure that all your VMs don't undergo maintenance simultaneously. And multiple fault domains ensure that your VMs are connected to different power sources and different network switches, both which increase availability of your VMs. We'll use the default recommendation for each of these options. Finally, I'll get a summary of my VM that I'm about to create. I'll press OK to kick off creation. Now, VM creation might take a few minutes. You can track the success on this tile in the dashboard or in the notifications menu above. If you leave this page alone, the VM blade will automatically open once it's been created. So now I can manage this virtual machine right from this blade. I can look at the activity log, diagnose problems, I can add additional disks or change this virtual machine size even after it's been created. Now because this is a Windows virtual machine, I can click Connect, and this will download an RDP file that I can then open. And we're now going to remote desktop into this virtual machine running in Azure in the cloud. And now here we are in a brand new Windows Server 2016 Data Center Edition, virtual machine running in Microsoft Azure. Make sure to click on the documentation links to learn more about common tasks associated with operating a virtual machine in Microsoft Azure.